Assalamualaikum and hi. My name is Ashikin and today I would like to share about mating system. A mating system describes how males and females pair when choosing a mate. Males and females differ greatly in the investment each makes to reproduce. Therefore, they may approach mating with differing strategies. There are three basic types of mating system that includes monogamy, polygamy, and promiscuity. In monogamy, both males and females have only one mate at a time. This type of mating system often occurs in species in which both the male and female are required to successfully raise young, or in which males have little chance of monopolizing more than one female. Monogamy is common in birds whose males can help incubate eggs and feed young. In a polygamous mating system, individuals have more than one mate during the breeding season. When males in the population mate with more than one female, it is called polygyny. Poly means many and gyn means female. Males compete for females and this leads to strong selection for traits that either attract females, for example, elaborate songs or calls, bright coloration and courtship displays, or allow males to compete effectively with other males, for example, aggressiveness, large size, and fighting aids such as antlers. Polygyny is common in species where males are less likely to provide parental care or where males are able to monopolize more than one female. Mammalian mating systems are predominantly polygynous, in part because young develop within and are then nursed by the female. In polyandry, andros mean male. Some females mate with more than one male during the breeding season. This is the rarest type of mating system. Females compete for males and may be larger and more colorful than males. In the spotted sandpiper, for example, females compete for territories in order to attract males. Once a male mates with a female, she lays a clutch of eggs that the male incubates. The female will then attempt to attract additional males for whom she will also lay eggs. Last but not least, in promiscuity, there are no pair bonds. Males and females often seem to mate randomly, as it is typically more advantageous for one or both sexes to pick their mate. Promiscuity may occur in species for which the environment is unpredictable. In conclusion, to transfer their genes to the next generation successfully, animals need to choose a suitable mate. Failure to do so leads to low or no reproductive success.
That's all. Thank you.